Donald Trump is coming for ESPN after one of its hosts called him a white supremacist and a bigot. This morning, the president of the United States tweeted, ESPN is paying a really big price for its politics and bad programming. People are dumping it in record numbers. Apologize for untruth. The president referring to tweets posted by SportsCenter host Jemele Hill. In fact, the White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders today calling Hill's comments a fireable offense. And she said that earlier this week. And she says the White House is standing by her statement.
I think the point is that ESPN has been hypocritical. They should hold anchors to a fair and consistent standard. ESPN suspended a longtime anchor, Linda Cohn, not too long ago for expressing a political viewpoint. The network's public editor has said that there is a perception that ESPN has become political and that has harmed the network. This is clearly a political statement. They should be consistent in whatever guidelines that they have set themselves in that front. John. Guys, I'm sorry, I'm going to try to keep moving so I can cover as much ground as possible. John, go ahead.
Do you still stand by your statement of the other day when you said that what Jemele Hill did was a fireable offense?
I do, and again, I think that they laid that out themselves by suspending one of their own anchors for political comments.
Keith Reed, former ESPN senior writer who knows and has worked with Jemele Hill, is with us. Nice to see you. And Clay Travis with Fox Sports Radio and founder of OutkickTheCoverage.com. Gentlemen, good to see both of you. And Clay, to you first, you know, of all the different columnists or even magazines in the wake of Charlottesville specifically that have called out the president as racist, why do you think he really took this particular target on, ESPN and Jemele?
Well, I think because ESPN's not in the business of commenting randomly on political-related issues. If you look at their history, they established about 18 months ago that they don't believe their people should be involved in non-sports-related political controversies. They suspended and then fired Kurt Schilling for saying that he disagreed with the North Carolina transgender bathroom bill. And that had absolutely nothing to do with sports. And they said, look, you can't have this opinion. It's too conservative. We're not going to allow it. I think that's a bad move. I'm a First Amendment absolutist. I believe in only two things completely, the First Amendment and boobs. And so once they made the decision that they were
I just want to make sure I heard you correctly as a woman anchoring the show. Did you say, what did you say? You believe in the First Amendment and BWBS?
Boobs. Two things that have only never let me down in this entire country's history, the First Amendment and boobs. So those are the only two things I believe in absolutely in the country. And so I don't think Jemele Hill should be fired, but I do think straight up that once you make the decision that you are going to let Kurt Schilling go, that you have to also make the decision that you're going to let Jemele Hill go. I think that's a bad decision. I think ESPN has made bad decisions that have led to 13 million subscribers bailing on the network. They've made bad decisions that have led to ratings collapsing. Jemele Hill's television show is collapsing. Ratings were down 20% last week over last year. I think that's why she's angry. I think that's why she went after Donald Trump. She's begging for ESPN to fire her so she can work somewhere else.
Okay. Keith, what do you think?
I'm astonished at almost everything I just heard. One of the things that, and Jemele's a personal friend, not just a colleague, but a personal friend. One of the things that Jemele's had to deal with her entire career, and many women who I'm friends with in this business and have been friends with in this business for a long time, is sexism, blatant sexism, comments about her appearance, comments about her racially, comments about her inability or perceived inability to be able to comment on sports because of her gender. For somebody to come on CNN and to say something like the only thing I believe in a discussion
I'm
about
just,
something.
I'm still there too, and I just want to make sure I'm hearing you correctly. B O O Z E or B O O B S? Because as a woman, I'm
as in boobs. I believe completely in the First Amendment and in boobs. Those are the only two things I believe 100% in this country. And by the way, Jemele has absolutely nothing
here,
to do with
live
her background
CNN,
at all.
Speaking,
immediately, did you notice that? He went straight to that.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Why would you even say that live on national television and with a female host?
I say it live on the radio all the time because it's true, and that's what I do. Because I like boobs and the First Amendment, which is exactly what I said.
Listen, Brooke, I think that speaks for itself. I love the First Amendment as well. I also love women, and as
you don't love boobs too.
I'm not going to talk about that on television because it's irrelevant to the topic. It shouldn't be brought up here.
Why not?
I am a supporter of women in their careers. I'm a supporter and a staunch supporter of women like Brooke, who I've shared the airwaves with before, and like Jemele, who is a personal friend of mine for a long time. And to have anatomy brought up, to have anyone's anatomy brought up in this conversation.
I'm done. This is done. This is conversation over. Yanking mics. Bye. See ya. That was entirely inappropriate, and it just took me. Forgive me that it took me a second. It's like live television happens, and you think you hear something, but you're not entirely sure, and then you realize it happened. So I apologize for him and that. Let's move on then.